Hey everyone, this video is about how you can contribute to Flipper Zero applications. I'll walk you through the process of signing up for GitHub, forking a Flipper Zero project, creating a branch, publishing your change, and submitting a pull request. I'll give directions for both macOS and Windows. Let's get started. Okay, the first thing we're going to do is open a web browser to github.com, and then we'll go ahead and sign up for an account. If there's not a sign up text box, look in the upper right corner for a sign up button. Next, create a password that meets the password policy. It looks like currently it needs to be either 15 characters or 8 characters with a number and a lowercase letter. And then finally, pick a username, and this username will be part of your GitHub URL. So pick a good username that represents all your GitHub projects. Next, you'll have to solve one of the CAPTCHA challenges and then click Submit. And then finally, type the PIN code that was emailed to you. You can now sign into your account using your email and password. Now that we have a GitHub account, we'll go to lab.flipper.net and then apps. And then we'll search for the app we want. In my case, I'm going to search for Lab 401 and choose the Light Messenger app. And then at the bottom of that page, you'll see a link to repository. And this will take you to their GitHub repository. So it actually takes you to the location where the application.fam is stored, which we looked at in my previous video. And so we're going to want to go to the main repository. So go ahead and click on the first part. And you should see that green code button. That's what we use to clone this repository. But instead, what we're going to do is go ahead and give that repository a star. And then under fork, go ahead and say create a new fork. A fork is a copy of a repository. You'll be the owner of this copy. And I usually leave the repository name the same as the original. If you know how your copy will be different, you can update the description. And typically, we're going to be editing the main branch that we're copying, so you can just copy the main branch only. Once you've made any changes that you'd like, go ahead and click on the Create Fork button. You can see the GitHub URL is now github.com/JamesonDemo/FZLightMessenger. And users can see that we forked this project from the Lab 401 repo. And our branch currently has all the changes that Lab 401 made. If it said you were out of date, you could click Sync Fork and then Update. For the next step, I'll first show the macOS version and then we'll look at the Windows version. And these steps should be familiar if you watched last week's video. So go ahead and click on the code dropdown and then choose copy URL to clipboard. With that copied, we're ready to bring up Visual Studio Code. So go ahead and press F4 and then type in code. And again, this Visual Studio Code we installed 2 videos ago. I'll go ahead and open our firmware repo, and then we'll go to View, Command Palette, and choose Get Clone Recursive. Go ahead and do Command V, click on Clone from URL, pick a folder that you want to store your repos in. I'll go ahead and just choose Repo, which we created in a previous video. And choose Select as Repository Destination. Once that's done, we'll go ahead and click Cancel. Then we'll bring up Finder, and we'll go into that repo folder, and we'll go into that Light Messenger folder we just made, and then the Lab 401 Light Messenger. There's our application.fam. So we'll go out one folder, we'll do Control Click, and then new terminal at folder. We'll type pwd. We'll do control and click on the line with the path and then choose copy. Back in Visual Studio Code, we'll control click on Applications User and we'll choose open an integrated terminal. And then we'll type ln-s space and then command V to paste in that path. And now we have a 401 Light Messenger app, and inside of it is our application.fam file.
On window, go ahead and open a new command prompt. So search for command prompt and then click open.
On some computers, you may have to choose run as administrator if you get errors in the next step.
In Visual Studio Code, right click on applications user and choose copy path. And then back in your command prompt, do CD space slash D and then control V to paste that path. So now that we're in that applications user folder, we need to find the path to our repo that we downloaded. So go ahead and open your file explorer. We'll go into repos, FC Light Messenger, 401 Light Messenger app. There's our application fam. So we'll go up one folder and then we'll right click on 401 Light Messenger app and choose copy as path. Then back in our command window, we'll do mklink make link slash D FC Light Messenger. And then we'll do control V to paste that path. It's created a symbolic link for our Light Messenger. We can close our command window and we can close our explorer. And there's our Light Messenger with our application fam.
Next, let's go ahead and go to terminal, run task, and choose release launch app on Flipper. Make sure Qflipper is not running and that your Flipper Zero is plugged in. We also should close Flipper Lab. It launched the app, so let me open Qflipper so you can see my screen. And there's the title screen for the application. Go into configuration, and you can see we have orientation, sensitivity, color, mirror, letter width, and word by word as options. So we'll go ahead and close Qflipper. Next, we'll add a simple feature to the app. We'll publish those changes. And then we'll create a pull request so the original author could choose to accept our changes. We'll open the app underscore params.h file. And then we'll set the param brightness config en to a 1, which enables brightness configuration. We'll go ahead and save our changes. And then we'll open terminal and then run task, launch app on Flipper. Again, make sure Qflipper is not running and you don't have any lab.flipper.net instances open. That works, so I'll open Qflipper. There's our config screen. And this time when we go into configuration, you'll see that there's a brightness setting that's currently set to blinding, and we can change the value of that brightness. I'll close Qflipper. In Visual Studio Code, I'll go to File, Open Folder, and then we'll open our FC Light Messenger folder. If we look in source control, we'll see that that apps params file was modified from a 0 to a 1. And we'll see we're currently on the main branch. I'll go ahead and click on the main branch and then say create new branch. I'll name it Jameson demo slash bright. And so now you can see we're on a new branch called Jameson demo bright. We'll go ahead and click the plus to add this file to our stage changes. And then we'll add a comment, add brightness option. And we'll go ahead and commit that change. Since it's my first time submitting code to Git, I need to set my email and my name. I'll go to Terminal and then choose New Terminal. And then in the terminal window, I'll type in Git and then config dash dash global user dot email. And then in quotes, I'll put my email address associated with Git. Then press return. Next, we'll do get and then config and then dash dash global and then user dot name. And then in quotes, I'll put my display name and then again return. I'll close the terminal window and then we'll go ahead and click on commit to commit those stage changes again. It looks like that update was committed to my local computer. So now I'll go ahead and publish those back to the cloud. It's my first time using GitHub on this system, so I'll go ahead and say allow. And then I'll log in with my GitHub email address and my password. Click sign in. And then I'll click on authorize Visual Studio Code and then open Visual Studio Code. And it looks like that was now published. In a web browser, I'll open github.com wack Jameson demo, and we can see there's our repository and our branch had a recent push 28 seconds ago. Click on compare and pull request. And you'll notice we're on lab 401. Not our repository. And our change is just this one change to turn config enabled to a one. And at this point, you would type in a title for your change and then write a little description explaining what the feature does and how to test it. And then click create pull request to send it to the original author of the repo. Once you're done with that pull request, I recommend you go back into Visual Studio Code in that project and you click on the branch and you switch back to the main branch. Switching back to the main branch will revert your code changes, but it will let you work on the next feature. And remember, once the author has approved your changes, go back and click on sync fork and then the update button. This will update your main branch with the latest changes. Back in Visual Studio Code, go to file and then open recent. And then choose the firmware project, switch back to the firmware. At this point, you would repeat the process for the next feature you want to add to the application. Hopefully this video showed you how you can contribute to existing Flipper Zero applications. Please like and subscribe. And if you have any questions, feel free to reach out to me in the comments or on Discord.